Speaking of eateries, Buffalo has one that's a real classic. Mike Randall reports.
It was the place to visit for a new and different dining experience in the 1950s. Back then, these shiny streamlined buildings could be found all over the country. In recent years, most of them have been squeezed out of business by the fast food joints. But Pete Cellino has hung in there, and today he's still the owner of Western New York's last original diner.
Today, it's become a classic again, and people are looking back to it. All of us are going back to some of the old stuff and appreciating its value more than anything else.
What made these diners unique is not only were they constructed of stainless steel, but they were all built and completely assembled in New Jersey by the Patterson Vehicle Company, stamped with a serial number, and then transported to their location.
It represented a tremendous cost to bring it here, and there was no throughway at the time, and so they had to follow all the back roads and be escorted by state police.
20 years ago, when Pete first bought the diner, hamburgers were 15 cents, and today?
I run a quarter pounder for $1.55.
Though the prices have changed, some of the clientele is the same as it was in 1955, when Robert's Diner was first placed on its site.
30 years ago, I directed traffic when this building was brought into and laid on this foundation, so I've been coming here that long.
This is friendly. I always feel like I'm coming home. I mean, this is real. The atmosphere is homey.
No, they don't have a drive-in window, no catchy Madison Avenue jingle, and no cutesy names for the food. A hamburger's just a hamburger. But here, you can still sit at a clean table, order a home-cooked meal, and pay a reasonable price. Nostalgia? Maybe. But let's hope it never goes out of style.
Judging from the past 30 years, I'd say maybe this has got another 30 years in it, I hope.
This is Mike Randall for Eyewitness News.